going on, everyone? Welcome back to the Lace Up With Mickey YouTube channel. Today I'm gonna give you 10 reasons why you are broke as fuck. Let's get right into it. Reason number one, you guys spend more time on the little TV, surfing the TV guide, looking for a movie or TV show to watch, then picking up a book, learning some educational content, learning a new skill. When was the last time you actually took the time to learn something new, to evolve, to become a better version of yourself? I guarantee if you're broke as fuck, you haven't done any of that. You've been spending the last 10 to 20 years watching your little TV. Stop watching fucking TV. Reason number two, you don't have any goals. When was the last time you took down a sheet of paper and you wrote down what you wanted to accomplish in life? Do you want to be a better person, a better father, mother, brother, sister? Do you want to help anybody, right? Do you have any financial goals? Do you want a bigger home, a nicer car? Is there anything that you truly want to accomplish for yourself to make yourself feel like you're actually working towards something that you're fulfilled in life? Is there anything that you've ever written down on that notepad that you really want? I guarantee if you're broke as fuck, you haven't written anything down. Reason number three, you're broke. You have no discipline. You start something and within a week or two, you quit. Why? Because it gets hard, you get depressed, things come up, right? Your family, you start blaming external factors besides yourself. And your discipline game is weak as fuck. I guarantee if you guys had some discipline, if you could actually deploy this discipline every single day, day after day, you would get shit done and you'd accomplish your goals. So if you're broke as fuck, you have no discipline. Reason number four that you're broke as fuck, and perhaps one of the most obvious reasons, is you don't save your money. You get your paper, you blow it on cars, you blow it on watches, you blow it on purses, you blow it on shoes, whatever the thing is that you blow it on, you know what I'm talking about, right? You don't save that money. And if you can't save money, you're never gonna be rich. Think about this, it takes 10 years saving $100,000 a year to get to $1 million. So if you're not saving, you're probably compounding that by 10x, you'll never be a millionaire. You'll never have financial freedom and you'll always need to depend on somebody else to pay your paycheck. Reason number five, you don't invest your money. Like we talked about, saving $100,000 a year would take you 10 years to actually save $1 million. But what if you invested your money? Let me give you a quick story. Back in 2013, I bought a home. I bought it for $110,000. I put $70,000 into it, $180,000 in, okay? Today, it's worth $375,000. So I had about 6 years of cash flow. I made $2,700 a month for 6 years because it's a duplex. Then I had it appreciate about 180 grand, okay? So I had the capital appreciation, I had the cash flow. How much money did I make just because I deployed my capital the right way? When you invest, you become rich. If you just save, at least you have some money. But if you don't save and you don't invest, then you're broke as fuck. Reason number six, you blame everyone else for your misfortune. It's Donald Trump's fault. Impeach Trump, right? You're one of those guys that sits there and lobbies for things to happen because you blame them for what's happening to you. Maybe you blame your mom, your dad, your brother, your sister, or somebody in your life that you blame everything for. Maybe you blame taxes, who knows? But the bottom line is you look for external reasons as to why you're not successful, as to why you're broke as fuck, when all you need to do is look at yourself. Right? Taking away all the external reasons, what is the difference between somebody that's you and somebody that's successful? The common denominator is you. The common denominator is not the external factors. So I guarantee that you are broke as fuck because you make excuses for not being successful by blaming everybody else. Reason number seven, you're happy coming home to the same house, the same car, doing the same job for 10 or 20 years. You're happy doing the same thing every single day. When was the last time you sought out some adventure? Do you have any desire at all to go on a vacation? Do you have any desire at all to live in a different home, to upgrade your lifestyle, to upgrade your knowledge so that you have a vast understanding of a different topic, so you can have conversations with educated people? Is there nothing that you want to achieve in life? Or do you just want to keep doing the same shit every single day until you die? Are you that much of a robot? Remember, we're all human beings, right? There's things that we're into. And all you're doing by doing the same thing, right, is you're digging yourself a hole, you're getting older, and at some point, you're gonna be like, where the hell did the last 50 years go? Well, they were spent doing the same shit every single day, and that is why you're broke as fuck. Reason number eight, you don't go to the gym and you eat like shit. Rewind the clock back to 2011. I remember I used to eat a burrito and a Dr. Pepper every day for lunch. I got to the point where I was 200 pounds. I had these love handles hanging off the side of me, right? I had this little double chin thing going on. And every day after lunch, I felt like I was gonna fall asleep and I wasn't productive for the remainder of the day after about 1 p.m. So I thought to myself, shit, this isn't working out. I'm not gonna have the stamina, the endurance to do this for 30 years if I keep beating myself up and punishing my body. So what did I do? I implemented a morning gym strategy which gives me an immense amount of energy in the morning, and I implemented a vegan strategy, which I do Monday to Friday during the week. Saturday and Sunday, I'm not gonna lie to you, I cheat, but Monday to Friday, at least I'm good, which means I get the utmost energy throughout the day so that I don't get tired, so that my productivity doesn't wane, and so that I can see every single day through as efficiently as possible. Reason number 9, you compare yourself to others. You don't understand that other people were blessed with different talents, right? Are good at different things. They are wealthier, richer, they travel more. You're always gonna find somebody that's better at something. And if you keep comparing yourself to those people and trying to keep up with the Joneses, you're always gonna feel bad about yourself when you come up short. So what do I mean? Maybe one of your neighbors drives a really nice car. So to compete, you go buy yourself a really nice car. Well, you just wasted all that money just to impress a guy that doesn't give a shit about you. Think about that. So one of the main things keeping you broke as fuck is the fact that you're trying to keep up with the Joneses. Stop keeping up with the Joneses. Stop trying to buy things to impress others. And I promise your life will transform. Not just that, but you're literally exchanging the money that you consume for money that you save and potential money that you could build wealth with over time. Reason number 10 and the final reason why you are broke as fuck is you hate discomfort. Every single time you go do something new and you feel a little tingle in the pit of your stomach, you quit because you hate that feeling. Why do you hate that feeling? Because you're terrified that you're gonna go and do that thing and fail. Let me tell you something, successful people that aren't broke as fuck, they get that little feeling and they push through because they know that little feeling is an indicator. It's like a spidey sense indicating that you're gonna be successful. It's indicating that you're working towards something that's gonna fulfill you. So instead of quitting every single time you get that feeling in the pit of your stomach when you do something new, why don't you actually persevere and try it? Why don't you actually do it over and over and over until you master it? That little shift in mindset will absolutely change who you are, and it'll make it so you will no longer be broke as fuck. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed those 10 reasons why I think you are broke as fuck. If you have any comments, hit me down in the comments below. I'll make sure to get back to you personally. I look forward to seeing you guys next time. Take care.